What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to Northern Valley in what I'm kind of calling like a progression episode, in that typically in these episodes I try to have like one project in mind and then we go through and we get it done. This episode kind of started out that way, but in the end we end up doing a lot of stuff and it's not all kind of done just yet. So yeah, you'll see what I mean by the end of this one when we go into the live portion. But yeah, we do a little bit of detailing, a little bit of building, a little bit of everything, but not one complete project, which I don't really like to do, but you know, stuff happens sometimes. So what are we doing first? We are going through and starting to put in some more public transportation. Now that is something that Northern Valley has kind of lacked for most of the series, I think. We started putting a metro line in at one point, and we have a few bus lines going around, but we really don't have any public transportation, and we especially don't have anything that connects to the outside world, so we have to do something, and I figured, why not put some train lines in? Now, I don't remember why I thought to do this, but it just, for some reason, it felt like putting a connection down, straight to downtown, was a pretty good idea, because I mean, I think you typically see that in a downtown area with really large hubs for mass public transportation. So I definitely wanted to try to get that going, but the weird thing is that it kind of goes against the plans that we had kind of set forward in having it like a suburban area connect to this. So I didn't really want to cut the suburban area completely in half by a train line, so we decided to run this through and around kind of on the riverbank. So you saw me in the beginning of this episode try to basically take the land down as far down as it could go without getting flooded and putting the key walls in to kind of keep the river at bay. And yeah, it worked for a while, and then I ended up in between saves here. I ended up reloading the game and for some reason it flooded. So in the end, I think I had to raise it up a little bit, but at this point in time we should be okay with it. So yeah, I don't know, I guess we'll take a look at it when we load the game back up. Hopefully it doesn't do that again, but you're seeing me now take some of these train lines and move it with the move it tool, and oh my, the move it tool is such a godsend for really anything in this game, especially trying to get rail lines to play nice together. And yeah, it totally helped here. So you saw me kind of adjust those down. Now, I really didn't talk much about the train station just yet, and I guess I could now, but it's a custom asset that I downloaded. I had a few things downloaded and I never really looked at them until this episode. So I found one that I liked, and it's cool because it's a really tall, big building. It's kind of like a grand terminal, if you will, but all of the train lines are underground. Now, I could have very easily taken just all of these train lines and just run them underground out to the outsides of the suburban areas that we plan to have, but I don't really like doing that. It's not completely realistic, so I definitely wanted to kind of avoid that. So that's why you saw me bring the train lines out from the ground and run those along the banks. Now, you saw me just place a bike path down there, and we still have to detail that. So I tried to go through with the terrain painter tool and get that rock texture to kind of be nice and neat, but there were some points where it would clip through and over the path. Not so cool, but yeah, we'll fix that with detailing. Now, I didn't do that in this episode. That's one of those things that I said we do a lot, but we didn't really get a lot of things completed. But yeah, that's something that we're gonna have to do in the future, in the next episode probably. But yeah, for now we're just going back, and I was trying to detail around, well, not detail, but lay out some pathwork around this downtown public transportation hub. You saw me put a subway system in there, and it's kind of weird because we'll go in the live portion and look at the subway, the metro line, but it's really close to another stop. I really don't know what to do about that. Maybe we'll adjust it later, I don't know. But now we're putting some parking in, and this is something that I really wanted to kind of keep in the theme of what we've been doing with our downtown. Now, I will say that by the end of this episode, the downtown area does grow. There are more skyscrapers, and I know some of you are probably excited about that. Some of you may not be. You're gonna like it, I think. I personally like how it looked. I took a lot of time in this in this episode to kind of like step back and make sure the whole skyline of the city looked nice. And we'll go and obviously check that out later. But I wanted to say the parking lots right outside of the terminal, I wanted to keep that. I could have very easily put like a big parking garage in and been like, this is fine, people would park here. But having the open air parking, it kind of gives the city a little bit more of that smaller city feel where we'd have a lot more space to work and put big public parking areas like that in. So I really enjoyed how that came out. And of course, you saw from one scene to the next, all of the cars pop in. I'm not going to bore you with placing all of the cars because that takes forever. And it's just not all that exciting to watch. But anyway, right now we're going through and putting some more of those taller buildings. Now, don't worry. The tallest buildings in the city are back near the other parts of the city by the bayfront. That is always going to stay like the marquee area of downtown with the tallest buildings and all that kind of, I guess, public interest space. But the rest of the city, I wanted to have some taller buildings, but nothing that's very overpowering. Like, I wanted these buildings to be something that you'd see in like a downtown, and it just kind of fills the rest of the skyline out. And I think we accomplished that, but of course, you guys can let me know in the comments when we go in and check this out. But right now, I'm kind of struggling with this whole road path area layout here. This was very, it stumped me. It really did. I haven't really had this much trouble laying roads out, especially in a downtown, like, metropolis type area, in a long time. And for whatever reason, having that one building on the angle near the roundabout, it really threw off the whole flow of everything, and for whatever reason, I just couldn't figure it out. But eventually, after many iterations, we kind of get something that works and something that doesn't look absurd. And it really, the thing that killed most of the attempts here was just the proximity in different intersections. When you have too many like intersections really close to each other, it really looks terrible. And it hinders the flow of traffic more than anything else. It doesn't work and it doesn't look good. So finding that little corner and finding a way to make that whole thing kind of work together was a bit of a challenge. But like I said, we get to a point where I kind of like it. And just trying to fill the rest of the space out with the roads here. And I, of course, made a really wonky intersection again in the main road, which is fine. It's going to work for now, and it's going to work in general, but you're seeing me right now on the screen kind of go in and fill out a little bit more of the space with some taller buildings. This is what I was saying before. I wanted to fill this area, and you see me kind of step back and take a look, and there's just like this one little gap in the skyscrapers that I really couldn't figure out how to fix, but we eventually figured it out. But yeah, like I said, I didn't want to have just these huge mammoth buildings that overshadowed everything else, but they were just kind of filler, and I think we did a really good job of keeping like a character for the city, but at the same time keeping it kind of, I guess, indistinguishable, if you could say that. But yeah, like I said, we're gonna check it out. So we're just going back now, doing a little bit more path work. I wanted to get some of the elevated paths going in this area specifically because there's that really big wonky intersection that I just talked about, and I really needed a way for people to kind of work their way around that intersection if they wanted to eventually walk through there instead of having to cross like a bunch of crosswalks and just having a flood of cars. And it's such a pain. And anytime in your city planning you can make pedestrians have a little bit easier time navigating, that's when you did your job properly. So right now we are going through and doing a little bit more shrubbery and detailing. And I'm using these trees here, the stock trees. They don't really look great. They never have. But unfortunately, a lot of the times in custom assets and just in the buildings that pop up, the growables, those trees are in there as decor. So, yeah, we have to kind of work with it, and I just thought I'd throw them in here just to kind of complete that area, fill it out just a little bit more to tie it in with this building that we have on the roundabout. Like I said, it's not the best tree, but it definitely worked together, and really, it doesn't fit this tree doesn't really fit the whole theme of the northern area or the northern feel that we have going in the city. But we had to do what we had to do, I guess. I'll bet there's probably a mod out there to change those trees on assets, or you might be able to go through and do it in the asset editor. I'll have to look into that. Maybe you guys can let me know. Yeah, I'm not really sure about that. But anyway, we're just kind of going through using the decals to build a little bit of a plaza here, just to kind of fill that green space that these buildings and these roads all kind of left. When you place buildings on weird angles and you have a bunch of streets kind of no longer in the grid, it creates a lot of open space. So there's you could look at it two ways. There's either a lot of room that you have to fill up and it's going to just be a pain, or it's an opportunity to get kind of creative. And that's what we did with a lot of these plazas. You're seeing me right now around this kind of weird building that I'll probably talk about in the live portion. Just kind of take one of those decals, and normally I really wouldn't like this decal because it's kind of like a snakeskin-y feeling, iffy decal in my mind, but it kind of worked with the theme of that building, I felt, so I guess that works. I really love these rock decals. I always forget about them, and then I put them down, and I just fall in love again with them. They're like little stones and little clusters of rock that kind of, it's like an intentional thing that someone put down as a design feature, but it looks great. And we use that to kind of fill up some of the grass space. And I think one of the last things we're doing here is just kind of working on this one skyscraper over near the construction site from a few episodes ago, a while back. And this was one of those skyscrapers that was in just to kind of fill the space. And then we go through with some tiles that match, like I said, and then these bollards. But the time lapse is now winding down. Let's go live. All right, guys. So here we are looking over the city from the Tri-Nova campus over here. And yeah, you can kind of see the progress that we've made. So up until this point, the city was pretty much just this. And it was tiny. And you know what? After I kind of built the college here, I figured we should probably expand the city just a little bit because it did look kind of strange having its own college, China having its own little bit of a skyline over here. So, you know, we kind of pulled it together, and I think this really, really fits the area quite a bit. So let's dig in here and kind of go close and check out what we've done throughout the time lapse. So let's actually start over here in the older parts. So we have this one really kind of tall, skinny building, which I figure is probably some sort of apartment, like a luxury high-rise or something. And it's a little out of place if you look at it from the side, but you know what? From the bay, which is probably what all of the pictures would, I guess, showcase? You know when, like, you see a picture of a city and it's usually one skyline or one angle of the skyline? I figure you'd probably get this from the bay over here to kind of capitalize on this city. But yeah, this tall building's kind of strange if you get over here because it is really skinny. But luckily we have a couple other of these filler buildings. I don't even know if that's the correct term. I think I completely made that up. But these are the buildings that are kind of taller than the other growables at this point. And of course we have a bunch of growables downloaded that are gonna get taller. Like the one right here on the shorefront, or the bayfront rather, is pretty damn tall, and it is completely there by virtue of, you know, growing to level 5. So we'll see that as the city expands and grows up, and it's going to be really interesting. I've been kind of waiting for that this whole series since we built this, but you'll see some of these buildings here, and they don't really play nice with the anti-aliasing or whatever you want to call that. Like, if you back up too far, it's a little wonky, but you know what, for screenshots, it's beautiful. So there's that. But yeah, let's actually, I guess, work backwards from here. You're seeing right now this plaza that we worked on kind of last, and we were putting these bollards in here, and they are just kind of there. Actually, over on this side, I kind of started over here, and I put these in because I figure, why not block this from becoming like a way cars would think to go, I guess? I mean, it's not like any car would actually hop the curb and go and make like a shortcut down there. But you know what? Crazier things have happened in cities. But yeah, I continued with the bollard kind of approach over here. and throughout here just to kind of differentiate these from roads. And, you know, we're not gonna really, I guess, mistake that, but I don't know. It's not, it's just something there. A little bit of detail goes a long way a lot of times. Now, this building right here on the roundabout, I really like, and oh my, the frame rate over here is atrocious. But, yeah, I love this building right here. It's got that, like, round element in the middle of it, and it's right next to the roundabout, and it's got a lot of, it's not really square. So, yeah, it fits perfectly, and I love the angle that we put it at. And, next to that, we have this other taller building with still a little bit of, like, curved influence at the base, but then as you go up, it more normalizes. And you'll notice that a lot of these buildings that we put down here in this new part are much more modern than some of the buildings that we have down in this, I guess, original part of the city that we intended to be, like, the old part of downtown. So I like how if you kind of back up and you look, there's, like, the older historic areas, and then as you kind of work out this way, you kind of get that new modern city feel. And even if you work this way, you have, like, the academy for, like, the school kids, and then the Technology Institute that we could, I guess, imagine had been part of, like, this academy and then kind of grew up to become this new high-tech part of a university. So, yeah, I actually dropped the disaster response unit over here for now. This may or may not be moved. I mean, it's a decent spot, and I had talked about putting this in a spot that couldn't, or I guess that wasn't downtown, and that has still access to downtown. So this actually is a pretty good location for this. Now, we could probably do it with some terraforming around here because it does look a little ridiculous, but yeah, we'll probably do that in the next episode. But let's check out the train terminal. I guess you guys can let me know in the comments what we want to name this train terminal or the train hub or whatever you want to call this. But, yeah, this is, I don't really remember what the asset is called. I guess I could look it up here. This is Suburban Station. I don't really see that as being suburban. I see that more as being a part of a downtown kind of building set. So that's why it's here. And you'll notice we could have very easily put more buildings at least right here. And then around here. Had some buildings to fill up the riverfront, but I wanted this to be kind of a little bit of a destination, kind of like what we have going on down here in the bayfront. Like, all of this is awesome, and this is the kind of thing where people would kind of come down to spend an afternoon, and that's how it was intended. So I'm kind of thinking along the same lines over there, and actually, you can see right now the waves of the river kind of barely not making it over the key walls here. That's what those are there for, I guess. And yeah, getting those tweaked out correctly was kind of an issue because of the way the water works in this game. But yeah, anyway, back to the riverfront here. I wanted to leave some green space. Now, I wasn't really sure what to do for the detail work, which is why it's completely blank aside from the paths that we have set out. And wow, that was strange. The subway car spawned. But yeah, I wanted to leave that for later, and then I wanted to kind of, I guess, take some influence as we kind of went through with the rest of the detail work, and we could probably take this run of the same shrubbery and expand that down to here, and maybe, hopefully, this building will disappear at some point because it is atrocious. That is so bad, but I think it's probably just a level 1 building at this point. But anyway, yeah, we're going to try to take some influence from what we did. And I wanted to do that first so I could do that and get that kind of laid out next in the next episode. But we do have this one little small square of trees and, I guess, grass over here. There's not really a story behind that. I just wanted something to fill that up a little bit more than to have just a really large patch of grass. But, yeah, we were talking a little bit in the time lapse of the parking lot, and I really love the open air concept. Now, you might notice that this grass strip is not a bike lane like we have around the rest of this area, and that's because I wanted to get this crosswalk to appear here. And if you didn't know this by now, you can change midway through, like, a segment of road and change it, and certain types of roads will change and create a crosswalk between the two sections. So that's what we did here, and I really like that being there because it kind of gives people a way, if they park over here and they need to go catch a train, to kind of walk up through here and then get right across there. So that's kind of the mindset there. Now, this building right here, the Home Plus building, I'm not sure what Home Plus is. It's probably some sort of store with home appliances or something along those lines. But I like this because it's a stranger building that we're used to seeing because it has a parking garage in it, but it's also got a storefront on the, front of it. So very interesting, and it fits this area because if all of this parking were to fill up, you'd have people being able to park in here. So basically it killed two birds with one stone, and I love having the decals around this. Like I said, I wasn't really crazy about these like snakeskin kind of decals, but I guess it fits with the color scheme of everything around here. But I like having the break in between here to have like a slot where cars would drive. Now, looking at this, there's kind of like some grass here that a car would have to hop over. I'm going to have to see what I can do about getting that remedied, but I'll work on it. No worries. Over here, not such a big deal, although there is kind of like this, whatever this info stand is here that you kind of get around the cities in this game, or not the cities, the streets in this game. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it for what we did. Now, this round building, real quick, is actually a circular farm, a vertical farm, I believe it's called, but it fits this area. Now, I guess it could be like a property owner taking influence, or a developer rather, taking influence from the technology school. Maybe they decided this is a good, cool place to try to grow crops in an urban environment, I guess. I don't know if we could really overthink this too much. But yeah, it'd be interesting to see if the pollution from the downtown area would actually affect that at all. But okay, so before we move on to the outro of this video, the terminal that we have, the train station that we have downtown here, is three lines of trains. Obviously, we have three lines coming out. And like I said, I wanted to kind of run this down by the river just to kind of have this space have a purpose more than having more development on it. So I like how this kind of breaks it up. And you kind of see this now and then around like suburban or just like the urban areas that are kind of transitioning into suburban areas. A lot of industrial areas will actually have this kind of feel to it. And I guess that's a thought. We could do some industrial stuff over here. But I wanted to kind of leave the industrial work for kind of down here because this is where all the natural resources are. So I guess that kind of would figure to be a good place for it. But these three train lines now, I guess we can kind of back out here and get a satellite image. But yeah, there's three lines here. We need to kind of figure out where those are going to, I guess, link up. And I'm thinking one of these lines is going to wrap around to maybe have a train station over here by this little square that we have set out, and then maybe have some sort of train line. One is obviously going to connect into the actual outside connection line, and then maybe have one run up this way, although I really don't know what purpose that would serve. Although, actually, we were going to put a harbor in here, so maybe we could link something up over here to alleviate car traffic. That'll be a future episode. We still have so much work to do in Northern Valley, guys. I know it's slow progress at times, but we're going to keep working until we get most of these major projects done. So in the next episode, we will be detailing the rest of the square that we kind of laid out here. We'll probably figure out what we want to do with these train lines. And that's pretty much it. That's all I'm going to promise. And I don't know, this episode got a little sporadic. You guys can let me know in the comments what you think of the new skyline for Northern Valley City area over here. Do you like the expansion? Do you dislike it? Why do you either like it or dislike it? And I guess if you liked this video, leave a thumbs up, of course. If you disliked it, leave a thumbs down. And that'll be it for this episode. Guys, I will see you next time back here in Northern Valley.